It is the Volkswagen Ameo that we've finally got for you on the program. I say finally because, well, it was first shown to us way back in February, and then VW has taken its time bringing it to the market. Even now, it's just the petrol, the 1.2, that's been launched, and the rest of the variants are going to follow a few months down the line, says VW. How is the petrol and what's the car like in terms of overall attribute? Ame and I drove it to find out.
There were a lot of expectations from Volkswagen when it announced the launch of a sub-4-meter sedan. The Ameo was unveiled in February at the Auto Expo, and VW is now hoping it brings it success. Success that has been very elusive for the German carmaker in India. And if the car does well, it may just rub off on one Ameo of our own.
Well, it's seldom that you get a car named after yourself. Well, halfway there, Ameo is far enough, I guess. But Volkswagen has come out with this subcompact sedan, which actually tells us how serious the company is about its India plans. Well, getting into the segment, which is already crowded by many rivals, Volkswagen wants to make a statement. And they did so by saying that it's made in India, made for India. What they left out, though, was that it's designed in Wolfsburg. But Volkswagen is very serious about this market, and we'll see the diesel variant come out by Diwali this year. But this one, for the time being, we have the petrol.
While at first glance it appears to be a Polo with a stubby boot or a Vento with a chopped rear, it is in fact neither. In a sense, 35mm have been shaved off the front bumper to make it look more proportionate from either end. It's a muscular front end too, and the lines on the sides give the design a flow towards the rear. It also gets a big lower air intake, and the air dam has a dash of chrome. The halogen headlamps are finished in black, and we do like the blue silk paint color. Now, we were told that the benchmark for its design were the Maruti Suzuki Swift Desire and the Hyundai Accent, which certainly comes as a surprise considering the Figo Aspire or Honda Amaze are the better looking cars in this segment. Volkswagen is offering only the petrol 1.2 litre engine to begin with, and this is a tried and tested mule in India. 73 bhp is what it produces, and there's 110 nm of torque on offer, and you might say the power is pretty sufficient for the segment. Now, the petrol is no rocket, and you understand that in the initial revs. Every gear change in the range of 2000 to 2500 rpm is met with equal delight, and there's a good amount of surge even when you're planning an overtake maneuver. But then again, there is no feedback if the needle drops below the 2000 rpm mark. The engine tends to get a bit noisy at mid to higher revs, but the gear shifts are smooth, and that's something you would expect from VW. It actually feels very similar to the Polo in its overall drive feel. The lack of power probably compensates for the fuel economy figures of 17.83 kilometers to the litre, and that is a big thumbs up for Volkswagen. On the safety front, VW has done well. ABS and dual front airbags are part of standard equipment across variants. ESP is also available from the Comfort Line variant up, but only on models with the DSG transmission, which is yet to be launched, of course. Now let's show you inside.
Now, the cabin is a familiar place because you've seen all this even in the Polo and the Vento, the black and the beige. And basically all the components here are from these two cars. But the flat bottom steering, which now comes standard, gives the Ameo a bit of sporty look on the inside. It's pretty nice to maneuver it. What it also has is ABS and dual frontal airbags as standard equipment. But what goes out missing is a seat belt warning sign or a seat belt warning light. So even if I do this, there's nothing, there's no sound at all. And I think those are the basics of safety, but somehow Volkswagen has given it a miss. Very sad though.
The wheelbase is the same as the Polo, and so you will feel a bit cramped at the rear, but there's enough boot space to gobble up your luggage. The 330 litres of boot space isn't the best in the segment though, with the Hyundai Accent that has a bigger 407 litre boot topping it. The Ameo has cruise control, automatic rain sensing wipers, power windows with one-touch operation, and even anti-pinch power windows. It also gets a rear AC vent and a front center armrest, but that's only available on the top-end Highline variant. The Highline variant also sees a touchscreen infotainment system with a CD player, USB, aux-in and Bluetooth. There's also Mirror Link, which does not support iOS but works on Android, and though we couldn't manage to connect an Android-based device, we were told that the problem was restricted to a few devices only. Volkswagen has managed to undercut all its rivals with the petrol variant. In fact, it undercuts even the Polo hatch. The Ameo petrol starts at 5,24,000 rupees and tops off at 7,05,000 rupees ex-showroom Delhi. We will wait for the diesel to launch, and from what we've heard, it will blow our minds away of pricing too.